apunté un desmayo. Y te lo juro que no vuelo. ¿Dónde está la plata que la vuelo? Yo estoy arriba en otro vuelo. Mis nietos dirán, diablo, qué duro era mi abuelo. Desde Colombia, parcero. Hace rato pasamos los 7-0. Tengo el cuello bajo cero. Sorry si sueno cochero. Colombia ya le llegó. México ya le llegó. Argentina ya le llegó. Venezuela ya le llegó.
Okay, so we're here with Roger from Essex Auto Enhancement talking about the Lamborghini Huracan Motivo in Arlon matte aluminium blue. And so Roger actually did the work on the wrap for this car. And this is third or fourth car that he's wrapped for me. And actually we got another project getting ready to go underway.
Yes, we did.
But I always kind of like to give Roger credit for all of the hard work that he puts into the vehicles. And let me just say this, like, so this is a really expensive car. So when you get somebody to work on a car like this, you want to be confident in the person that you have working on your car. And so Roger's someone that comes highly recommended because of the care and precision that he puts into working on a vehicle. So he doesn't do just anybody's car, but if you have, you know, a high-end car that you want to get detail with the attention and maybe do a color change, for example, then this is definitely who I would recommend. So I wanted to kind of give Roger some time to just talk about his work. As you see this beautiful spec of a Lamborghini, and you know, anything you want to share with what went into getting this thing done?
I mean, the first thing was this vehicle had been wrapped multiple times. I think you had said was the three prior wraps.
Yep. Yep. I had a matte red and
this is the fourth, I believe.
Yep.
So obviously, when you're wrapping a vehicle, of course, to get a seamless install, you're looking to tuck film into sort of body lines and things. Believe it or not, I actually found evidence of the three previous wraps when I was prepping the car, unwrapping the satin red. There was strips of the satin white. There was the orangey matte red, I think you'd had on there. And then, of course, the satin as well. So a lot of labor went into first initially thoroughly prepping the car. And as with anything that you do on a vehicle, whether it's paint or detailing or vinyl wrapping, if you put that extra time and effort into the prep work, ultimately the finished result is going to showcase that. So previous wrap shops that had worked on it had obviously unwrapped it, but as I mentioned, there were multiple fragments of all of the different wraps you had stuck in crevices and cracks and things. So I spent that extra time with tweezers and little trim tools just to remove all that. And then once that was out of the way, really cleaning all of the body lines, all of the panel gaps, removing residual adhesive, grime and everything that built up since it was last wrapped to get it as flawless as it could be before the new material was then applied to the surfaces.
So what would you say is the most challenging part of wrapping the Huracan? And just for reference, Roger actually wrapped my Aventador SV. He wrapped an Audi S6, did a phenomenal job on both, and the Audi was actually white.
Yes.
The Aventador was red like this.
Yep.
So, and you really can't see any traces of, it's really hard to find like red on the SV. So maybe if you could talk about like what it was like rapping this as compared to some of the other vehicles.
The DNA between the Huracan and the Aventador is sort of similar in terms of the body architecture, the design. I would say overall this is a little bit more petite than the Aventador, of course. The fact that this one doesn't have the scissor doors is a huge bonus from a rap perspective. We did not choose to do the door shuts in this because of the longevity of this vehicle in your collection. But what that meant was I still had to remove the glass to access the mirror bolts as I did in the ESV, which in itself is pretty labor intensive. That involves removing the inner door panel, which is beautiful black Nappa leather and Alcantara, so a lot of care removing all the piano black trim, masking off the leather and the Alcantara so there's no damage done to that. Once the door card is then removed from the door, it's a question of removing all of the speaker system, all the associated furniture of that. And what that then does is allows you to access the two window regulators that you need to undo to then slide out their entire window pane. And that is effectively to enable you to access the three Torx bits that hold the mirrors on. So, you know, when people think of wrapping a car, they think, well, surely it's just applying the vinyl to the surface. Well, it is, but a lot of the time, particularly in a car like this, is very much in that prep work, that disassembly, to get a clean, seamless install. So there's no seams, the vinyl is completely under the mirror, all into the door handle as well. And obviously, it's a very expensive car. I think the retail price for a wing mirror, for instance, is close to $3,000. It's $2,000 for the side mirror glass if you can get some.
Yeah.
So, I mean, any competent mechanic can sort of work on the car, but obviously you just need to have that little bit of extra care when you're teasing the glass out of the panel, moving it out of the rubber gaskets and things as well. So you kind of have to have your wit about you and do it very methodically, and obviously spend that time making sure everything's marked and then go back as it was to factory specifications in terms of where the glass is then situated in the frame. So all of the regulators and hardware is marked accordingly to get it back to manufacturer specs. So the glass goes up seamlessly. There's no wind noise or any leaks or anything crazy, you know, in your ownership following the brand.
So I got to give Roger credit again. Like I said, takes meticulous detail and when he works on the cars, and he actually found some little issues with the car that he just took the initiative on kind of taking care of for me. So there was a little nagging problem I had that you discovered that I didn't know was the issue. I had a problem with the fluid for the washer fluid.
Okay.
And you found an issue with the connection or something with the
So you may still have it. So what I did, so the problem is, I mean, you take it obviously to these shops. They come highly recommended. They did a good job. But I think there's a degree of sort of expediting the turnaround on vehicles. And I think ultimately that means corners are cut. For instance, I shouldn't be finding evidence of
previous
white and wraps. It's just shoddy workmanship.
Yep.
You know, why did I spend sort of 3 hours taking the door apart when I could have cut the same corners? It's because I care. You know, I love working on this car. I respect what it is. And I want to maintain the quality of not only my install, but rectify any problems that I find when I'm in there. So the previous wrap shops had effectively broken the two tabs on the windscreen washer covers. They had used some pretty primitive putty to sort of bridge the gap in the crack to hold them on. What I did is clean that off and then epoxied them so they're on there, they're good to go. Someone unfortunately had rounded off one of the main Torx bits, so my first chore of stripping off that passenger side door was I no longer had a clean head on the Torx bit to put my tool in. So I had to use little grub screws effectively to drill out that old Torx bit just so I could get the door card off to then start the rest of the work.
Right.
So again, you know, someone probably used the wrong size socket or something. Perhaps they used an impact gun. again, the door card was on there, it was all put away, but the problem is the next person that then goes to touch it, undertake work on the car, then has to, you know, rectify that problem.
So got it.
I had to remove that, replace the Torx bit. Then someone had also had the bright idea of plasti-dipping over the regulator. So as I said to you, if you're doing this correctly, what you want to do is actually mark the position of the regulators, the washers, the T-clamps, so you can get the glass back into the frame in factory specs. Someone had the bright idea, instead of using a Sharpie, which is the go-to tool, the ink can then be removed with a bit of isopropyl alcohol, they'd literally taken a can of plasti-dip and sprayed over their entire regulator. Now, obviously, that had done a great job at marking it, but that rubber compound was now in all of the crevices, and when you're trying to remove glass that should be sliding in a nylon regulator, that rubber compound made life extremely difficult for me to physically move the glass out of the rails.
Wow.
So again, you know, someone else had been in there. It's little things like that that obviously slowed me down. I then take the time to rectify it. So once I did get the glass out, all of that was cleaned off and everything was put back as it should be. The other, and I don't know what it is with the passenger door, the first thing that I found was your interior grab handle was effectively hanging off. If you looked at it, there was a huge gap between the plastic maintenance surfaces, and again, someone had obviously had it off and then carelessly put it back on. There's a lot of
tabs and
spring clips
okay.
in there, and you have to make sure that when you remove it, you realign them all, so when you get it on and you push it, everything seamlessly goes in. If it's off by a millimeter, it means the plastic that should go into the snap clip will potentially fold over and bridge. That had happened on here, so there was two broken clips. I had to remove those, remount the spring clips, and then get the grab handle back on so it has a nice OEM fit and finish.
Awesome.
I appreciate stuff like that. You know, especially with a car like this. It'd be one thing if it was a Chevette or, you know.
I mean, for me, it's not acceptable on any car.
I know that.
I don't care if it's a Honda Civic or obviously a $250,000+. Huracan, it's just uncalled for. Now, obviously, I could have done the same, shrugged my shoulders, said it's not my problem, sort of swept it under the mat, but that's not how I go about things, doing what I do. That's why it often takes me a little bit of extra time.
But I thought it was done. I thought it was done in pretty quick.
It was done quick, but what I'm saying, if I had a virgin car that had never been touched before, I would have ultimately been able to sort of prep the panels, and away we go. Everything would have been fresh, but you could see there'd been multiple people in there over the course of your ownership with the wraps, and there were just little, you know, niggles that needed addressing.
Well, it came out spectacular, and there's some other things that I want you to kind of go over that I thought were pretty cool, such as the awesome finish on those tires, man. And so this is something different and something at least new to me.
Yeah.
So if you want to like maybe kind of show us what you did there and on the tires to get them to shine like that.
Yeah, so one of the Achilles heels of whether it's nice paint or wraps, particularly when they're in a matte or a satin finish, is tire shine sling, whether it's from your car or a car that you're running with, if you're cruising together. You know, there is a way to, of course, apply tire shine correctly, but unfortunately, a lot of people, it's the last thing they do. They put a lot on, and you get sling. Not only do you get sling onto the bodywork, but tire shine can pick up dirt and dust and grass clippings, everything on the road. So what we've done with this vehicle, I've been testing this for the last 2 years, is we've effectively coated the tires in a permanent tire dressing. So they look incredibly glossy and wet and rich, but if you touch them, they're completely dry. So what that is a permanent polymer coating that is on the tire to give you that UV protection, to give you that gloss and shine, but without the associated maintenance that you have with traditional oil-based dressings.
Okay.
So what it means for this car is you effectively do not have to reapply your tire shine the next time you detail it. You just have to wash the sidewall of the tire with regular car shampoo, dry it off, and you're good to go. So it means from this car, there'll be no risk of slinging tire shine and getting that griminess on the side of the wheel and everything else that tire shine can do.
Awesome.
So I think it really sort of accentuates the color of the car, because you have that depth not only from your gloss black wheels, but now that extension onto the tires themselves. So,
love it.
Quite labor intensive to apply the product. I like to apply it preferably on a brand new set of tires.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, these tires are not new, they've had countless coats of various tire shines. So the first thing that I had to do before coating was to do around 6 different cycles per wheel, degreasing and really agitating all of the lecture in the grooves in the tire to get it back to virgin rubber, that neutral finish. And that's paramount to really then allow the polymer to adhere to the tire. If you attempt to put it on and sort of cut corners again with the prep work, the product will fail, it'll flake off, it won't adhere to the surface. Get it right and it looks as it does on the car as we see it.
Man, I love it. So less maintenance due to Essex Auto Enhancement and his knowledge of different products like this to try. I think it looks spectacular.
Yeah, I mean, the sort of inner wheel arches were just caked in obviously old tire shine.
Okay,
I mean,
okay.
Even when you put it on and you're kind of careful with the application, ultimately on a car like this, particularly with the top tire and the arch gap, you're going to get some sling, you're going to get residue thrown up everywhere. We've now effectively eliminated that problem. Not only do you get a tire that looks infinitely better than traditional tire dressing, you eliminate all that maintenance and mess that's associated with it as well. So hope you'll enjoy the upkeep on these and having fresh looking tires.
Absolutely.
Every time you get the car.
Absolutely. So again, big thanks. I appreciate all the hard work on the vehicle.
Absolutely.
And the professionalism. And I don't know, is there anything else that you like folks to know? You know, because I know if I was watching and folks that might know me, I mean, if I recommend you, I think I would listen. Anything you want folks to know as far as, you know, how to get in touch with you if they might want to partner with you on a vehicle?
Yeah, I mean, as you mentioned, where all my details are on Instagram. My cell phone number is there. Feel free to DM me, send me a text. Happy to discuss options, quote on the phone or email. The contact details are there. And I always like to speak to someone just so they understand what the expectations are in terms of selecting a film, the differences in the finish in terms of the associated maintenance and longevity, and then walk through the project and sort of educate them in terms of what's involved. I mean, every car is very different. You know, some vehicles, there is no need to sort of remove glass and the extent there is on these. That's just how these were designed. So obviously the client needs to understand that you're going to be pulling apart the car. Some people are completely aware of that, you know, aware of removing emblems and all of that good stuff. But yeah, reach out to me and get you a price.
So how about this? We've got another project getting ready to happen. So how about we take a walk over to the next project? So for those of you that stay tuned, we'll give you a sneak peek at my next project that Roger is actually going to take in his hands and knock out for me. So let's talk about that one next. All right, so Roger's actually taking off in the work truck here. This will be the next project that he will undertake. You guys can guess the color that it's gonna go. Drop me a comment, you know, you guess the right color, you get a free t-shirt. But wow, the funny thing is, I actually saw the color in the parking lot. Coincidentally, but yeah, this is gonna be a nice monster truck. Might even do some wheels on it. You know what? If you could. All right, so there it goes. We've got there we go. Next time you guys see this, it'll be a new truck.
It's the one and only Floyd Money Mayweather. I'm here to tell you guys to go to Wheel Motivation. the exotic cars is crazy. I've been watching this show for a little while now and it's growing. But we need everybody else to subscribe to Wheel Motivation and support Wheel. I'm supporting them. You do the same.